Hey there, and welcome to today's video where we will be discussing calorie restriction, the dieting equivalent of being grounded for a month. Many people believe that the only way to lose weight is to cut calories and eat less. But is this method actually effective, or is it just a recipe for a mental breakdown? Today we'll take a closer look at the real science behind calorie restriction and whether or not it actually works. So make sure to stick around till the end of the video or until you get too hungry and go raid the fridge. So what exactly is calorie restriction? It's basically the practice of telling your stomach to shut up and stop growling by reducing your daily caloric intake. This is often done through a combination of reducing portion sizes and choosing lower calorie foods. It's like a game of Jenga, but instead of pulling out blocks, you are taking bites out of your sandwich. Now, does calorie restriction actually work for weight loss? Well, it can lead to weight loss, but the effectiveness varies from person to person. And let's be real, restricting calories can be a real pain in the bum. It's mentally and emotionally exhausting to constantly monitor and restrict your food intake. It's like being on your first date and having to watch every word you say. It's just not sustainable. Plus, let's not forget that willpower is a very limited resource. You will crack and start snacking on anything you can get your hands on. It's a vicious cycle of guilt and overeating that's just not worth it. Now let's talk sustainability, or lack thereof. Sure, cutting calories might help you drop a few pounds in the short term, but can you keep it up in the long term? Let's face it, saying no to pizza and ice cream for the rest of your life is like trying to resist a puppy's cute little face. It's just not going to happen. And let's not forget about the impact on your metabolism. Eating less than your body needs can make it slow down like a sloth on a hot day. Your metabolism slows down in an attempt to conserve energy. And don't even get me started on nutrient density. Just because something is low in calories doesn't mean it's good for you. I mean, you could eat nothing but kale and be as skinny as a toothpick, but who wants that? It's important that we eat enough nutrients, minerals, vitamins, and antioxidants that allow your body to function properly. But fear not, my friends, there is a better way. Instead of torturing yourself with calorie counting, why not focus on small, sustainable changes that won't make you feel like you're on a never-ending diet? Think of it like training for a marathon instead of sprinting to the finish line. So put down those celery sticks and let's explore some better options. Number one, reduce insulin levels. Insulin is like the annoying micromanager at work who won't let you get anything done. High levels of insulin will make your weight loss a lot harder. But instead of quitting your job, just eat more whole foods like veggies, proteins, and healthy fats. Try adding into the mix some intermittent fasting and low-carb, high-fat meals, and you will be on the right track. Number two, reduce uric acid levels. Uric acid sounds like a character from a bad sci-fi movie, but it's actually a waste product that can cause weight gain and other metabolic problems. So make sure you drink plenty of water, eat alkalizing veggies like broccoli, spinach, and beets, and limit or eliminate sugary drinks and alcohol. And if you do decide to indulge in a steak, maybe skip the martinis. Number three, don't let your thyroid get lazy. Our thyroid gland is like the control center of our metabolism, and we don't want it falling asleep on the job. So eat more iodine-rich foods like seafood and eggs, get your heart pumping with exercise, and maybe try some stress-reducing yoga poses. Namaste. Number four, sleep your way to weight loss. Who knew that sleeping was the secret to weight loss? Getting enough sleep can actually help regulate our hormones and appetite. So snuggle up in your cozy bed, turn off your phone, and say no to that tempting midnight snack. Number five, stay positive and stay motivated. Having a positive mindset can help us make healthier choices and stay on track. So set realistic goals, be kind to yourself, and surround yourself with uplifting people. And if all else fails, just pretend you are a motivational speaker and give yourself a pep talk in the mirror. You can buy yourself flowers. You can take yourself dancing. You are strong. You've got this. Number 6. Don't let stress weigh you down. Stress can seriously mess with your hormones and appetite, so it's important to find healthy ways to manage it. Maybe take up a stress-busting hobby like pottery or kickboxing. And if all else fails, just scream into a pillow for a few minutes. Number 7. Practice mindful eating. Mindful eating means paying attention to what we're putting into our bodies, and it can help us make healthier choices and avoid overeating. So put down your phone, slow down your chewing, and really savor every bite of food. And hey, maybe even take a food pic for the Instagram. Number 8. Feed those gut bacteria. Gut bacteria might not sound sexy, but they actually play a big role in our health and weight management. So chow down on those plant-based foods full of fiber, sip some kombucha or kefir, and maybe even try your hand at making your own sauerkraut. Your gut will thank you. Tip number 9, don't be a night owl. Sorry night owls, but eating late at night can seriously mess with your glucose tolerance and metabolism. At night, our body is not as efficient at utilizing and metabolizing nutrients. The body is better at metabolizing nutrients in the first part of the day, because all the body functions, they follow our circadian rhythm. So maybe save that midnight snack for the next morning and indulge in some bacon and eggs instead. Tip number 10, don't let emotions control your eating. We've all been there, eating our feelings instead of dealing with them. But instead of turning to a tub of ice cream, try talking to a friend, taking up a new hobby, or just taking a few deep breaths. And if all else fails, just let yourself have a good cry. Tears burn calories, right? Now to sum it all up, yes, calorie restrictions can be an effective way to lose weight in the short term, but it's important to consider its sustainability and impact on metabolism. If you are choosing this method for your weight loss journey, make sure to only reduce your calories by 200 to 300 calories per day maximum to avoid all the problems we discussed earlier. But if you are one of those people that like to work smarter, not harder, follow the 10 steps to lose weight we discussed in this video. And if you want to learn more about insulin resistance, uric acid, and their roles in obesity, make sure to check my other videos about that. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe.